In today's video, we are going to cover how to create your actual podcast using a previously recorded StreamYard video. Now, it really just depends on how you create your podcast content, on whether you just want to use the audio only or the video as well, but I'm going to show you how you can download both so you can make those decisions for your podcast. So let's go to the computer and I'm going to show you how it's done. Okay, so I'm in my StreamYard account, and the first thing that you're going to do is go over to past broadcast. Now, this is assuming that you've already recorded your episodes. Make sure you go check out the other videos on StreamYard's channel that shows you how to record a solo episode or an interview podcast. So once it's all finished and you've recorded your episode, go to past, and I am just going to grab a previous live stream that I want to use that has multiple people. So this episode down here is actually a podcast episode for my show, the Proffitt Podcast. So if I click on the ellipses button, you can see I have multiple options here. I could download the recording, I could embed and share this particular video. If I wanted to just share it with my audience, I could send them this link. If I want to look at what it looks like on YouTube, I could look at it here. But what I want to do is download the files that were used in this podcast recording. So I'm gonna click on download recording. And I love that now StreamYard, like, you have so many files in, you have 50 hours of storage, so you don't have to worry about, you know, if, oh, like, it went away or it's not there. Like, it's still there. You don't have a time limit of when you absolutely have to go get it. And so what I love are the options. Oh, this is life-changing, y'all. You don't understand. Before StreamYard was around, this was such a complicated process. But what I love is you have the option. You can grab all the videos that are included in this recording. This was actually an interview between myself and five other people. So that would be six separate videos. Or I could just do the audio recordings, or I could do the individual audio recordings. So many options, but the decision that you have to make for your podcast is, are you gonna have a video podcast? Are you gonna have just audio only? Or are you gonna work with all the different audio tracks? So once you make that decision, you can know whether you want to download the video, you want to download the audio, or you want everything to be separated out for the audio recordings. I will tell you, as someone that has edited tons of podcasts, I like dealing with everybody's individual audio tracks whenever it's just audio, because it just helps. Oh, it helps so, so much with the editing when you can manipulate each individual person's audio quality. If somebody is higher, if somebody is lower, and you need to really balance out the levels, it definitely helps to have those individual audio recordings. And there's one more feature that I wanted to point out that is pretty cool in StreamYard. So if I'm over here at that same podcast interview that I previously did, I could click on the ellipses and go to stream recording. Now, what does this do? This allows me to stream this out as if it were live, and I could interact in the chat with my audience while it's streaming. So I could go to click on stream recording, and then it says which recording is selected up here. And then I can decide, well, I want to air this on my YouTube channel. So it gives me the option of, when do I want to start this? When do I actually want this to go live? Well, if I were trying to promote the podcast whenever that podcast episode drops, and I wanted to have this entire interview played, then I could make that happen. Now, I'm gonna be really honest. I know that this particular episode was not edited the way that I would typically edit something for my YouTube channel, so I wouldn't air this. But if you have a great production during your live streams and everything ran smoothly, then I think that this is a great option for you to stream it out whenever your podcast episode drops. So I could select the start date, the start time, I could put the title, whether you want to name it something related to your podcast would be great. You could put your description, whether you want it to be public or private, and then you can actually schedule in announcement post, which will let people know kind of like when you schedule a live stream, that, hey, like this is coming, and they'd be able to set a reminder and be notified whenever your stream goes live. Well, I hope you were encouraged and inspired by today's video to keep streaming and create those podcast episodes and figure out how you want to set up your video podcast or audio only, or how you want the live aspect of your show to play into your streaming and your podcasting, because I think that the two just go so well together to give you the ability to interact with your audience, share behind the scenes, and really share the podcast experience with your listeners. But that's all I have for you today. So if you enjoyed today's video, make sure you hit the thumbs up and subscribe so that you don't miss out on future videos that StreamYard puts out every single week. And make sure that you keep streaming.